going all the way left, yeah, and trying to do something there, it's perfect because it allows you to close the distance really, really easily. And you guys, as we discovered again, you want to fight at the short range. Potentially, yeah. Junkrat could be setting up another angle, because what will be happening is if you, on this side here, all of the enemy resources are going to be dragged towards that location. That means their shields, that means their medics, that means their shots going to be there as well. And if they're shooting you, that means they are going to pay less attention to the flank, and it will be easier to execute something like going for the tire, or maybe, let's say you have somewhat other ultimate that's going to be easier to execute. And that ultimate is also going to give you value.
Hello, my name is Gefest and I'm an Overwatch coach. In this video, you're gonna see me coaching a university team. I'm gonna talk about important aspects of planning and how to adjust your playstyle depending on your team comp, just fundamentals. Also, if you want to book some coaching with me, then you can find a link in the description to this video.
I think, because I did watch your Anubis game, we can maybe start with that, because today I wanted to talk about fundamentals. I really wanted to talk about kind of like what is the most important for you guys, because yeah, like, you know, if you have the strong fundamentals, you can be really successful as a team. And also we can talk about somewhat important aspects of team play. Yeah, that's what we can be focusing on today. So my first question would be, what do you guys think is the most important thing about team play, actually?
Planning and execution.
Planning and execution, right. Any other thoughts?
Good comms.
Good comms, sure. Anything else? Okay, well, good comms. Sure, go ahead.
I was gonna also say, like, not like communication, but more of self-aware, like who's where, basically, which kind of fits into communication, I guess. Mm-hmm. Like spatial awareness almost of where your teammates are.
Exactly. Yeah, all of this stuff. Yeah, it's really, really it's really, really important. And what you said, kind of good communication, good sort of knowing, reading of information of the field is important. Yeah, and it's all kind of connected to the good planning. So maybe what we can do is to start with one of your replays. So maybe let's start with that Anubis game and think about. Okay. First of all, think about important aspects of planning. I would phrase it this way. And the second thing is to, which we can be paying attention to, we can pay attention to fundamentals of how to play your comp, and specifically which you guys had there. So let's see.
Real quick, just saying, like, really quick, because of, like, the Wi-Fi currently being bugged, I may have to ask, like, if there's something on me or something for the team, or like something that you're saying about a play and I can't hear, I'm sorry ahead of
I
time.
I can type it out
if
you want to.
If I keep
to.
Saying like, I guess, but I don't want you to like type every like single sentence and phrase, you know.
Mm-hmm. Are you guys?
Because then I'll feel bad, because then it's like Haley will be like, all right, I'm gonna type down everything this man says.
No. I mean, someone's recording here though, right? Or not?
I'm recording.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, that's good then.
Yeah. So yeah. Right. So the we have a recording as well, so you can watch it later. But let me just screen share here. Okay. So that's I think you. Yeah. That's your replay, I think. Okay. So that should be Scream, right? The Anubis game here.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you have anything specific to mention about this game?
I have a feeling that we lost the final push on the second map because Mercy was rezzing and my aim kind of sucked at shooting the Mercy.
Yeah.
Okay. I felt regret ever since that.
I also feel like around at this point, we were all like all over the place because of what happened before. So okay. I feel like a lot of our like, some of us weren't as focused, or some of us were like really focused or trying to be like focused.
Mm-hmm.
Because like Haley, you remember what happened, like, 15 minutes before the game started. Like, yeah, right?
One of our members just kind of, like, we couldn't get in contact with them at all because their power went out and their phone died. So, like, we didn't know what was up.
So,
yeah, it was kind of stressful.
We were, like, 2 seconds away from forfeiting.
Oh, yeah, I see.
It was pretty close. So, I feel like this particular, like, these games, I feel like I could feel it, like, in communication and whatnot, that we were, like, all slightly, even me, I was, like, we were all slightly off, it feels like. Because of the whole thing that happened before.
So, do you think we can get better games, or it's fine if we kind of, like, pay attention to those and still talk about fundamentals, plan in a little bit more?
I mean, we're assuming for, like, right now, for, like, this semester, that was, like, the worst start that we're going to have, right? I'm imagining all the other starts that we're going to have are going to be a little bit
I have match rods from, like, super before, but they might be outdated, because the last one Matt posted was, Chris Providence College, like, 10, like, in October. I have, like, my own match VODs, but, like, I'm not playing with the team, so it's, like... But I might have posted some match VOD info of us playing together. Let's see if I can get the
code. Okay. Maybe let's sort of then theorycraft and try to, like, maybe let's say our communication was not the best here on Anubis in specific because of some things which happened before, but maybe we can kind of, like, theorycraft and get some thoughts about what good planning looks like. And so, like, here in specific, when we start in this map, right? Because you guys mentioned that it's really important to be focused on what you do. Yeah, it's really important to know where you are, what you're doing, right? It's all kind of the parts of having a good plan, okay? So right here, did you guys have a plan in specific? Or because of the things which happened before, you was not be able to make any plan?
I think the plan was just brawl and then get high ground and try to get.
Well, we were trying to go. All of us were trying to go right. Like, our ideal objective was we would all go top right.
Okay.
And Orion would block to get us up there, and Lucio would speed us to the high ground, so we make sure that, like, no one dies.
Okay.
And then we try to, like, control high ground, and if one of us, for example, got booped down or fell down because they found, like, a kill opportunity, we were gonna, like, join that person.
Okay.
If they were to jump down.
Okay, to me, it sounds like really, really decent plan, because a lot of teams, I would say, they really struggle with having, like, actually having a plan, I would say, or, like, having a consistent plan. So, like, if you guys did have the plan which you just told me now, that's really, really good. Yeah, obviously, right now, we cannot hear the comms because we just have this replay code. Maybe later, that's something we can be paying attention to. We can be paying attention to communication specifics, kind of, and making sure you guys communicate correctly and everyone knows what the plan is. Yeah, but at this moment, maybe we can pay attention to actually, like, execution and understanding of the plan. So right here, you have this specific comp, so Reinhardt, Zarya, Lucio, McCree, Baptisto, so right, okay, with the Junkrat. So what is the plan with this team composition? What do you guys think? So yeah, sure, you get the high ground, but then what's gonna happen later? How do you guys actually win the fight?
I usually, like, go back to help, like, because sometimes our tanks, like, overextend just for that extra security of the Immort, but also, like, for window, I usually, like, mid-team fight, I'll, like, pop into, like, get rid of their, like, Rhine Shield and, like, try to burst them down. And, like, put pressure on them, usually.
Sure.
Honestly, I didn't really like the Zarya, but that was just me because I was sick by saying that in the comms, too.
We did not know that they had Echo Widow, but I picked Zarya because, well, one, I didn't know that they were going to have Echo and Widow. That was the first thing. Two,
okay,
is when we got high ground, because, like, let's say if someone does fall off, then I would have the opportunity, if I could see them. Like, it depends on where they drop, but, like, assuming that it's right, like, not, like, right next to the wall, then I could possibly bubble that person, and if he's saying that I'm down, or she's saying I'm down, then we can all, like, join in, and hopefully that person doesn't die.
Okay.
That was kind of the thought process with Zarya before I knew what they had.
Yeah, I would say, right, there's a lot of specifics of what you guys can do in a fight. Yeah, like everyone should know what they need to do in terms of specifics. But in terms of, so like, because you have this team comp, we can sort of think about, first of all, at what range are we going to play, actually? So it's pretty simple because the team comp is just there to give you an idea of what you're doing. So it's sort of like connected to having, you know, a proper plan on the map. So right now we can kind of start with, okay, our team comp, is it, should we play short or long range? So what do you guys think? If you kind of compare your team comp to the enemy team comp, is it, should you guys play short or long range?
Short, I think.
I would say either short or medium. That's what I would say, short or medium.
Okay, so
I
that's
agree with
definitely
short or medium.
Yeah, so that's fundamentally like basically what you want to ask yourself, are you guys going to be stronger to short or long range? And here let's kind of think for a little bit, why are we actually stronger at the short range versus these guys here?
Because Widowmaker excels at long range, plus the Echo prefers to out imagine like most of the time, unless if she's using her beam, she would prefer to be far away.
Exactly.
And she, because she doesn't have the most HP, so
Exactly. So in terms of specifics, right, these guys really like to keep the long range. That's really good to mention that. And later we just wanna kinda see, are we actually closing the distance with the enemy? Are we actually fighting at our favorable range? And in terms of specifics, everyone can be doing their specific thing. Like maybe, okay, let's actually kind of start with Zarya. So let me see. So you, actually your name is Nicholas, right? Am I pronouncing it correctly? Okay. So in terms of specifics, what are you going to... nice. Well, so in terms of specifics, when you're trying to close a distance with the enemy, what you need to do? What are you going to be doing?
First, I'd imagine since Zarya starts off with zero charge, I'd imagine I'd have like two objectives to kind of be able to fight in that close range and be like threatening, right?
Mm-hmm, sure.
One would be to try to get charge, right?
Okay.
So then I can actually do the damage to be a big threat if when we get to that point. And two, try to protect people from dying so that we can make it to the high ground and we can, like, initiate.
And what do you
have? I would say those are, like, the two.
Okay, right. Okay, and what about so Haley? That's. Am I pronouncing it correctly? Sorry, if I'm not.
Yeah, it's me.
Yeah, nice. Okay, what about you? What are you gonna do?
I kind of usually try to stay with Ryan to kind of like stay with him. And maybe I'm not sure, like, because I'd usually stay on. Let's see. I'm thinking. Hold on. Sorry. I think I'd like try to stay with like our tanks and like just make try to keep them up while we speed in and just make sure like no one gets picked in the process. While maybe trying to like fire at the other Rhine's barrier to try and like chip away at it. So like by the time we get like high ground, maybe we could like have a bit more like oomph to our push.
Okay. Okay. And what about Reinhardt? So a giraffe, right? I'm pronouncing it correctly. Sorry. Okay. What about you?
Really just stay in the front of the entire team and try to block as much damage as possible.
Right. Okay. Okay. And I would say that sounds good to me. Oh, overall.
Someone turned on.
Oh, hello?
Hi, Warhood.
Hello, hello.
Good Warhood?
Yeah. All right. So let's continue. So, I would say that sounds good to me overall. And in terms of specifics, that's something you guys can be discussing later, kind of in your war reviews, in the one-on-ones too. That's something we can do too. But currently here, well, making sure, like for the most part, fundamentally, that you guys are on the same page, that's really, really important. When you're looking for, when you're looking to execute your plan. So right now we know that we need to fight at a short range. In terms of specifics, Azari need to have charge. Maybe Haley will be supporting Reinhardt, and then Reinhardt will be blocking all of the damage, sure. let's see how it goes. So we're starting here at the gates. Mm-hmm. By the way, in terms of specifics, that's something we can discuss later, kind of, you know, discuss every piece, like what you guys should be doing. But at this moment, let's kind of pay attention to our fundamentals. So now we need to close the distance with the enemy, trying to go through the gates. By the way, stream is working just fine, right?
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah.
Nice, perfect.
Yeah, stream's mm-hmm. working good.
Okay. Going after the high ground, and we sort of start here. Okay, let's see how it goes. Mm-hmm. Okay. So, how do you feel about this? So, with information which you knew before, right? Which we know, which we discussed before, because we just said we want to fight at the short range, right? We want to try to close the distance at some point. So what do you guys think about this? Should we be playing on the high ground here then, or not? Should we try to do something else?
I would imagine that we would try to... Like, because I feel like we kind of are achieving the... The short range, if that makes any sense, like the mm-hmm. enemy's down there and we're up there, so mm-hmm. we have the option, like, okay, whenever, like, I feel like the correct option would be for one person to, you know, say that they're going down and then everyone, like, follows at this point in time.
Exactly, exactly. So trying to, like, go after someone mainly here, what you're really looking for is to close the distance with anyone who is the easiest. So let's think about who is the easiest target for us to close the distance with here, maybe, from their team. What do you guys think?
I think we try to, like, speed boost and try to, like, get the Baptiste in the back since he's, like, sure. the majority of their heals.
Sure, sure. Sounds good to me. So, Baptiste, maybe Reinhardt too, right? You can try to close distance with those guys, try to, like, run them over. So, in terms of specifics, what you're really looking for, in terms of expectations, yeah, like, I don't want to go too much in depth, right? But anyway, ideally, we want to make sure we have our resources. We can phrase it this way. So, in terms of resources, that's our bubbles, that's a mentality field, that's our maybe Lucio speed boost and our Reinhardt shield. Okay. So, when you're trying to do all this closing the distance, just make sure you have all of that. And then later, you're going to be using this bubbles or shields, whatever, or speed boost to actually help you to close the distance. So, that's the first thing. Okay. And then let's see how it goes. For the most part, in my opinion, like, if the enemy team, they're gonna play it correctly, it should be not in your favor, sort of, because Echo will be taking an angle, the Widowmaker will also take an angle on you guys, and because they are actually playing for their advantage, they're playing their favorable range, so long range, they might win it. Okay, so our McCree dropped by accident, I think, but what's happening later? Okay. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Actually, kind of, you know, still sort of even, but we can anyway see, yeah, that these guys, they had more advantage on the map just because simply of the range we're playing at. Do you agree with that?
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
So let's take a look at the next fight. Okay, so in terms of plan, let's kind of theory craft a little bit and let's think about what our plan can be now. What we can do now as a team in theory.
Switch to somebody to take out either the Widow or the Echo.
Okay, sure, sure. So, like, that's might be a good option. Anything else?
Trying, like, to go knowing that we need to, like, mm-hmm. I'm not sure if we thought about, like, I don't think we brought this up, but, like, mm-hmm. I would say one thing would be maybe trying to find the quickest way to shorten the distance. So, like, for example, maybe instead of going, like, all the way up to the right, maybe we could have, like, gone, I don't know if this would be a good idea or not, but, like, maybe go straight, I would say, or, like, speed straight.
Sure, I would say like anything else, like even, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Even though it sounds like really basic, but it would be like a fast way to shorten distance.
Yeah, I would say that's totally reasonable. So thinking about how to close the distance in a more reasonable way, right? Trying to like maybe save your resources, make sure you use those to actually help you to close the distance, and trying to do something like that, right? So what you described there, and also that thing which we which you told me about, kind of dealing with a Widowmaker, maybe all those things are really specific. Okay, so our plan can be around somewhat specific play, or let's phrase it this way: our plan can be around somewhat our abilities or our kind of cooldowns. Yeah, let's phrase it this way. And mainly, what you're looking to do is when you don't have your ultimates, is to actually do this kind of, you know, set up this specific play, make sure you execute it. But when you do have your ultimates, usually you want to have a plan which involves your ultimates into it. So not currently we have a Zarya, currently we have a Beat, because ultimates are really powerful tool. We all know it, right? So because of it, it's really easy to win the fight with those. That's why we want to kind of theory craft plan around those a little bit more. So what do you guys think, if you would try to plan around your ultimates, what good plan would look like?
Sorry, Haley.
No, it's okay. Haley can start.
Haley, you can go first, then I'll like tell my thing.
Sure.
Oh, I was just gonna say like Zarya and Jekyll, maybe.
You keep cutting out after you say Zarya.
Oh, yeah. just Zarya and Junkrat's ult with the tire together.
Sure. Okay. Sounds sounds good. And any anything else we can be doing also?
I would, if I were to, like, this is theoretical, right? If I were to grab a decent amount of people, we could try to Lucio like Beat into it, so then we could negate all the damage and try to kill them.
Okay.
Like that.
Okay. So you see, like, all those plans, by the way, which you described to me, they are connected to our previous fundamental thing, which we just discovered. Us fighting at the close range. So if you do all of this, maybe you guys are gonna try to go for the Lucio Beat, maybe you guys trying to like grab or something like that. That all requires you to close the distance. So ideally, yeah, if you executing this correctly, should work. It's just something you guys need to be aware of, kind of being on the same page, making sure that everyone knows what they are doing when we have this plan. By the way, who is responsible for planning in your team?
All of us. We kind of just say something and we're like, we all agree on it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'm usually the most like active in the comms when it comes to like telling people things.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like mainly I would say like kind of like the three of us mostly, maybe like Ski sometimes also does it, but I would say it's more of like a group. Would you say this like everyone? Would you say that?
Yeah, like I would say it's like a group consensus.
It's like if someone has an idea, we try it, and we try like our best to try to make the team comp around it. But we would also like hear opinions back from our team and whatnot. So.
Mm-hmm, sure. I would say it's okay if you have everyone sort of short calling, and if it's working for you guys, I would say it's fine. Yeah, just ideally, anyway, fundamentally, want to make sure that's happening. You want to make sure that planning is happening on the map. And I mean, yeah, like in your game. So when you're looking to do things, mainly what you need to answer is what you're doing, when you're doing, and where you're doing. Okay, so what we just mentioned, we can be maybe Zarya grabbing, or maybe we can be Lucio beating, something like that, close in the distance. Let's answer the question when. What do you guys think? When you should do it? Because it's kind of a tricky one, I would say. But
I guess since like our ults would be like Zarya's ult is not like like how do I say it? I would imagine when we would use it would be like based on our previous plan. Like, so last plan was going right, right? And I think I'm not 100%, but I'm pretty sure we do that this time. But when we go
yeah, we right, go right again.
I would imagine what the when would be when we start to drop, I would say.
Okay.
And the enemy team's close. Okay. I would say that would be the when.
Mm-hmm. So when you guys drop, maybe you could also mention something, because this plan involves your grav into it. There is a danger for you of not using your grav properly. What is that? What can go wrong with that grav? Like, potentially, if you take a look at these guys here, what they can do versus your
D.Va,
grav.
D.Va, I would say, is the first thing that I look at.
D.Va, Madrix, sure. Okay, so she can
I would also
grav.
Say, I would even say, like, a bit of... Like, I feel like Ryan would be... Not Ryan, but I would say, like, Echo, because she can kind of fly really fast if she does notice it.
Yeah, potentially someone can also escape because of their cooldowns, right? I would also say that your Reinhardt, I mean enemy Reinhardt, can potentially block all the damage. That's why we need to be aware of that, maybe try to burst his shield a little bit, but mainly the main concern is the Madrix. And for that reason, because you need to know what kind of things are there to actually stop you ultimate, yeah? You need to also, like, keep that in mind. Yeah, like when you're doing things, you can be just saying, okay, maybe guys, let's force D.Va Madrix and then let's try to grab after that. Maybe let's try to break the Reinhardt shield a little bit more and try to grab also. In terms of where, we already answered that. Yeah, sort of like dropping on the point. Yeah, that's where we're doing things. Once you guys went right and once, yeah, reach that top, sort of. Let's see how it goes right now. Let's kind of... Okay, maybe let's just play the bot here. So you guys going right side again. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, Junkrat just died there. Because you guys were... let's maybe discuss. What went wrong right here? Why did Junkrat die? What, like... We could be doing better potentially.
He's wearing two pills as much as we thought before. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah. Junk was just a little bit too far behind.
Mm-hmm. So kind of again, if we connect it to what we said before, because we need to be on the same page when you guys doing a rotation, when you're doing certain thing, when you're doing certain plan, we always need to make sure that we are together doing the same thing simultaneously. So maybe we can just say Junkrat, like, next time you guys are gonna be in this game, we can just say, well, Junkrat have to be aware of this stuff, kind of like play with you more instead of being isolated. Or you can just also kind of say that, well, instead of going in first, kind of trying to rotate first, make sure everyone's around, everyone's protected with your shield. But yeah, let's see how it goes later then. We going at the high ground and enemy team is trying to, like, take a fight there, sure. Okay, actually Junkrat got a pick now. That's fine. Okay. So you guys use the high noon. Okay. Let's kind of think about this. Did you plan this or not?
No, actually.
No. Mm-hmm.
No, and then
did you have a plan which involves your ultimate, though, at this moment?
Honestly, I'm not too sure.
I don't think we should. Sure. Mm-hmm. I think we just kind of saw it take the point.
Yeah, that's why that's something you can be guys paying attention to when you're making a plan, kind of involving your ultimates first, making sure that you kind of creating plan around those first and later executing it. Because when, you know, when everyone not sure what's happening, when you don't have a clear plan, then you don't know how to set up. And that's like the extra layer which we can think about. So when you making a plan right after that, it sort of looks like that. Okay, we're making a plan and then we look into setup. Okay. Let's imagine we're looking to grab right here. So that was our kind of like serial plan. Okay. The Zarya wanted to just like, we as Zarya wanted to grab there. We wanted to grab the point. How we would set up accordingly to that plan? How everyone would kind of position himself. Maybe let's start themselves. Let's start with a Haley. Where you would position if you knew that this plan would be happening here?
Like if they're grabbing, like where to do after?
If we're grabbing, yeah, at the moment, where you could be positioning then?
I'd probably try not to get picked by the Widow, but if everyone else was dropping down, maybe I'd like for like a second, like stay on the high ground and then drop down to try and like contribute to some damage, maybe.
Okay, sure. What about Nicholas?
I would. I would imagine if I were to grab, I would imagine we would try. Well, I would also try to. Probably, if I was in that position, it depends if Ryan was there or not. But if he like was in a different area, then I would probably bubble myself because their first reaction would be to like shoot. Mm-hmm. If that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
So I would try to get some charge and also do damage. Like I would go in on the grab.
Yeah, sure. I would say that all of that makes sense, right? Then there are other specifics, like, for example, in terms of your DPS, like your McCree and Junkrat. Also, you guys together in a team, right? With the McCree player and with the Junkrat. Okay, so that's good. That's something you can discuss later, kind of like also making sure that you set up accordingly when you have a certain plan, because like at this moment when we're looking for High Noon currently in terms of setup, I would say that's something you can work on. Maybe like our setup right here is not ideal, I would say. So yeah, we looking to execute our High Noon here, and then later when we drop in on point, right, we're taking a corner. But what we could be doing instead, so again, we know we need to close the distance, but right after the High Noon, should we just stay at the corner, or could we close in the distance with someone?
I think we can close the distance and try to like get up in the face, but be careful.
Yeah, exactly. So usually you can always think about this when you guys are using certain resources, when you're using your ultimate especially, that's forcing enemy resources, and that's forcing enemy cooldowns. Once enemy cooldowns are forced, you can actually capitalize on it. So like at this moment, they use the maybe Diva Matrix, or they use the Reinhardt Shield, and that's something you want to capitalize on and try to fight at your favorable range, try to close the distance. So that's something you could be looking to do. It's just kind of a little bit more so you guys sort of have a disadvantage when you fight in the long range, as we said before. But let's see. I think you're still gonna take the point though, because the setup was actually pretty good with a High Noon, kinda. So we just gonna see. Okay, got the point, and then gonna push this second here. Alright, so what kind of plan we can have now? What we can do now? What do you think?
I imagine. Well, first would be like what we have, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like right now we have junk tires. I would imagine maybe all of us grouping up and trying to find a way to close the distance, whether it be, I would say the best three would probably be like obviously left, right, or forward.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then I would imagine. Like, this is how I would imagine it. Like, if I looked at it right now and I, like, paused time, Junk would try to maybe flank with his tire.
Sure, I would say.
Get a different approach,
mm-hmm.
considering we don't have, like, too many ults right now. If we were to use Junk ult, that's mm-hmm. how it would be. Mm-hmm. That's, like, my thinking of it.
Yeah, like, honestly, I would really love to hear what was happening here, maybe hearing you guys kind of, like, saying what you exactly gonna do at this moment, because, yeah, you do have a tire, but it's important to kind of phrase it, like, make sure we kind of build a plan around this, because what you just said, kind of going all the way left, yeah, and trying to do something there, it's perfect, because it allows you to close the distance really, really easily, and you guys, as we discovered again, you want to fight at the short range. Potentially, Junkrat could be setting up another angle, because what will be happening is, if you, on this side here, all of the enemy resources is going to be dragged towards that location. That means their shields, that means their medics, that means their shots going to be there as well. And if they are shooting you, that means they are going to pay less attention to the flank, and it will be easier to execute something like going for the tire, or maybe let's say you have somewhat other ultimate that's going to be easier to execute. And that ultimate is also going to give you value. That's what we call like taking off angles on the map, especially like in this current meta in Overwatch. And I would say like it's been really long, like taking angles, just making sure you set up someone on off angle when you actively doing something is really, really important. Mainly when you're playing Brawl, you have somewhat like McCree or maybe Reaper. These guys can be taken off angle, or currently here is a Junkrat. So yeah, okay, let's see what we're doing though currently.
I think we decided to just push up here, I think. Because we have this Lucio speed, so oh never mind. We actually went left.
Okay.
I thought it was either left or we went straight in.
So yeah, like let's pay attention to specifics. Okay. Right now we're trying to go in, we're trying to close the distance. Let's pay attention to bubble, right? For example, like right here, we're using bubble on Reinhardt. Is it good or not? What do you think?
This moment I thought it was like an okay, I feel like it could have been like maybe saved, but I thought it was an okay decision, because it's like because Ryan's gonna be moving up, which means that a lot of people are gonna be like shooting him.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
So yeah. I thought like maybe that could like protect him a tiny bit, or maybe it might make the enemy team like I wasn't sure if they would shoot him or not, like with the bubble, because like they're, you know, I mean, obviously they're going to shoot him, but I didn't know if they saw the bubble and then they'd be like, okay, like maybe let's not shoot, or let's keep shooting him.
Yeah, I mean, like, you don't have to kind of, well, you can make it simple. Just, like, think about it simply, well, we're going in, we're doing something actively all here, we're on the same page. So, like, we want to invest our resources in our favorable location, if I phrase it this way, like, currently here, we're closing the distance. So if I use my bubbles here, that's pretty good, because we have an advantage in this position. If my Reinhardt swings, that it means you enabling fighting him in the close range, which is good. So that's good. If you used your bubble early, let's say right here, then it's bad, because you're using your bubble really, really far. So like fighting in the long range, you know, trying to like get value out of your resources from the long range, if we phrase it this way. Okay, so like you use the bubble right here, enabling the Reinhardt, that's good. But then in terms of other resources, let's think about Baptiste. What kind of resources you need? Like Haley, what do you need?
I think I probably, maybe when we start taking like damage, like bubble was gone, like shift, like for the regen ability. Mm-hmm. And then like when Ryan was low, I try to like, you know, inward so that we can have that final push to take out their Ryan. Mm-hmm. Try to like out sustain them. Sure. I also have like window, so I can like pop in.
Yeah.
Maybe try to increase the healing.
Yeah, I would say that's really, really good, right? Like having your shift, having that immortality field also. That's what we need to kind of enable this aggression at the short range. Okay. And then in terms of Lucio, what do you guys need like from your Lucio here?
Probably like an amp. To help us like further get the heals, or like either speed if we want to like really push it on them. But okay. It kind of depends on like what we're gonna do, communicate.
Yeah, because like at this moment, in terms of specifics, we had this shift. We also had those bubbles, right? I think our Reinhardt also is full shield here. So again, we have Giraffe. You have this like full resources, right? So your armor is there as well, and so most of our specifics are there. The only thing which you're missing, I would say, is the Lucio's amp, and I would say, let's take a look at your tracer. Okay. So like your tracer is right here. So we're actually missing one player when we're going in. Yeah. And as we said, kind of like making sure that you're on the same page is important. And that's why I'm making a call like, okay, guys, I'm pushing like 3-2-1. I'm doing something and making sure everyone able to follow up on this and everyone has their resources is really, really important. Let's kind of think about the tracer. What kind of resources tracer needs when this is happening?
Like maybe if they were flanking their tanks, like just be like cautious of their health, and like maybe I could just like shoot a grenade their way to try and like sustain them while we're pushing in still.
In terms of what you can do to support Tracer, that sure, that something can do to kind of throw your shots or your healing at her, but if you are Tracer right here, what do you need to be effective in the fight? Let's talk about your own cooldowns. Like, imagine you guys are Tracer here, what do you need?
Imagine I would want to make sure that I would have enough, like, blinks. I mean, I don't play too much Tracer, but I would imagine, yeah, like, I would need enough blinks to be fast and move around the map.
Okay. Okay.
Like, when I
guess, like, recall and, like, at least, like, one.
Yeah, at least
blink.
Recall as well.
Yeah, exactly. So, like, right here, yeah, your Tracer needs blinks. Why it's important? Because when we have blinks, she can stay out. She can stay in the fight here as much as possible, dodging all those cooldowns. And also, yeah, recall, right? So that's something you guys need to be aware of, right? Because like right here, when we pay attention to this, like we can say in terms of specifics, yeah, our Tracer is not in now, but we in already, like the rest of our team is in already, and that's something you can fix later, kind of doing those individual war reviews or trying to do war reviews as a team as well, making sure you're on the same page, making sure everyone can follow up. Okay, well, I also want to add one more extra layer, because when you do the plan, like when you do certain thing on the map, like you
I'm
said.
I'm gonna be like muted for a little bit, just letting you know.
Okay,
that's
I'll
fine. Still hear it, it's just, you know.
Yeah, it's alright. Well, so one more extra layer here when you're actually doing the plan is ult tracking, okay? Who is responsible for ult tracking? If you have one, of course.
I usually like try to remind people on the team, like in the comments, be like, hey, just be careful, they might have ult, or like these people mm-hmm. might have ult coming up and mm-hmm. stuff, like on the enemy team, if you mean like that type of ult tracking. For us, like I always try to like check like all the ults and just be like, okay guys, like here's what we got like coming up or whatever, like for everyone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like exactly. So like having someone ult tracking, making sure that you ult track what they have can actually change your plan. And let's say like this fight, I think you guys should be sort of winning, right? Oh, sorry, what you said? Oh,
you lagged, Nick.
Please, can you repeat?
Yeah, sorry about that. I like my thing lagged out really bad. Sorry.
No, that's alright. Okay. I just want to kind of... Oh, okay. We got two ticks, and then later we're trying to do something on the map again once we respawn. Okay, so like right here, if we think about this, that might not be the best example because the enemy team, they don't have their ultimate C yet. And let's move to the next fight here. Okay, so let's think about this situation. If you guys are ult tracking and saying they have something like Baptiste window and Lucio, okay, how it can affect your plan here? Like if you know that information, what your plan, how your plan would look like, let's phrase it this way.
Like if we knew they had window, like going to the left might be a bit dangerous, we'd have to like push through it or something. Because he's probably gonna window through that like corridor or whatever. Or like if we went main, we'd also have to be careful. Like I guess we just have to be more careful and like use more like corners, or be more like aware of like trying to avoid getting shot through the window if we knew he had it.
Okay. Yeah, so like you can clearly see why wood tracking is important in even this small thing which you mentioned there, like when you know that they have a window, maybe what you can do is to just go past the window. Yeah, it's all part of your plan. Once you did this proper ult tracking, you can execute your plan really, really well. And let's actually see how we executing, like what we're doing on the map now. Is maybe let's just go with perspective of Ryan for now. Okay. We go on the left side. Making sure everyone passes here, sure. And then now we're gonna look to close the distance. Okay, actually, was a little bit luckier that we got Baptiste right at the start of the fight. But let's say. Like, because when you ult-tracking, what you need to say is what kind of ultimates they have and what ultimates they close to. So if you did proper ult-tracking, then, well, you probably know that they have this Lucio's bead, they have this window, and then they have this May. And if we're making a plan around those ultimates, what can we look for when we're going in? Again, like, May ult is also kind of dangerous, so what do we can look to do with our plan to play around it?
Try to maybe put a lot of pressure on May, maybe.
Sure.
And Baptiste.
Sure, we can maybe put some sort of pressure. Anything else?
I would say, I'm not sure if we were aware, or like noticed, or like notified that May's ult was ready, because I was not aware, I'll be honest. But I feel
I feel like
the best way to do, like, to have it is to know it, so then I can, like, maybe pay attention to when she, like, throws it. So, like, I would probably have to be more focused on it, or, like, if another team calls it out, or if I notice it, and I call it out, you know, I feel like that would be the right play to go to, at least for the May.
Exactly, here, what you just described also, when you did this proper ult tracking, once you execute in the plan, everyone should know what they're doing. So you in specific, as a diva, you'll be like, oh, okay, we know that they have a May ultimate, we know that they have a window, they also have a beat, but I really want to be aware of the May ultimate, because that's something I can eat, maybe also potentially Baptiste window. So in terms of resources, what you have to save then?
Imagine I would have to make sure that I try not to use the visor, or I would say use it very limitedly, because like it all depends on when May throws her thing, right? Or when Baptiste sets up his wall, because that's like when I really need it.
So
the most
because you said visor, I think you meant matrix, right?
Well, I meant the wall that
visor
Baptiste creates. Yes.
Oh, okay, right, okay. So, yeah.
I had a major brain fart for some reason. I thought Baptiste was, I don't know why, I thought for some reason Baptiste was set a soldier's ult, and I'm like, oh, I gotta get ready for it.
Imagine.
I highly doubt I thought that in the game, but like right now, since it's Friday, I feel like it's just Friday brain mode, so.
It's alright. So, yeah, anyway.
Or as I like to call it, Friday mode.
Yeah, like, what we just said there, anyway, there are sort of specifics which you can be paying attention to once you have this proper ult tracking, once you execute in the plan. So, like, right here, yeah, when we are doing it, yeah, because let's say, if I was aware, like, if I was actively searching for the May, maybe something like this would not be happening. I would be saving this matrix. I would be saving, like, my cooldowns to actually make sure I will eat that May ultimate and maybe eat that Baptiste window as well, if that's gonna be, if that's will be happening. And I will set up accordingly to that, okay?
I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
You could eat the window, though. You just eat the bullets that come out of it, right?
No,
I meant like shots, yeah, just shots in general.
Okay. Yeah, just shots through the window. Imagine that would be like totally busted.
Yeah, that's. Could be really, really good, actually. Right.
You just click, right click on the wall, and then it's just gone.
No.
Imagine.
Yeah, because like here what went wrong really is that we kind of were not playing around their ultimates. I would say that's why Ultraking is important, but let's see what's gonna happen next. Okay, because this fight is lost and we're gonna be on defense. Okay, let's see here. Okay, I think that's where it's starting. Okay. Mm-hmm. So we on defense. Actually, our comp is a little bit different now. And let's think about this again, because our team comp gives us an idea of what we do on the map. So if you compare your comp to the enemy comp, at what range you're gonna fight?
Mid far range, maybe.
I feel like it would be more like maybe a medium range. I feel.
I feel like muted. Definitely mid range.
Yeah, I would say so. Like here, because you have the Reaper. Okay, so the Reaper is a short range character with a D.Va. You also need to close the distance with someone. The D.Va is just really, really strong at the short range. Reinhardt's kind of the same, and then Zinyara is strong at the long range, soldier long, and Baptiste also mostly long range. And in terms of enemy team, D.Va is a short, Genji again really really sweating at the short range because of his right click. You can do 168 damage potentially with the headshots and then follow up with the dash. Echo also at some point she needs to close the distance. Reinhardt short range, and then so that's a long. Echo I would say long short sort of, because usually you want to start really really far and with Echo and then close the distance and try to beam someone, try to get a kill with a beam this way. Okay, so because most of these guys, like, they are, you know, more of a shorter range than us, we can say we wanna keep the distance because we kind of try to let them in and then use that advantage on the map, like maybe try to use the corner here, try to use those advantageous positions, try to look to go in, like our Reaper can look to go in and maybe do something our Reinhardt too. And because we actually allowing them to get in here, our soldier and our Zinyara can have easier time to land their shots, land their abilities too. Because simply here, if you let them in a little bit in theory, let's say maybe if our Zinyara is over here, for example, yeah, our Zinyara will be able to actually avoid enemy Reinhardt shield, because the Reinhardt shield will be faced this way, maybe potentially we can be avoiding Reinhardt shield and shooting their backline, which is really really good. That's what I said before, taking an off angle, kind of setting someone an off angle is important. That's something we can talk about more, a little bit more in depth, but yeah, definitely kind of letting them in, that's what you do, is good. Okay, and in terms of okay, let's actually kind of take a look at the first fight and see how it went. So what do you guys think, what went wrong here, what we could do different?
I think the positioning maybe of like the supports were kind of bad, because like when Echo picked off Baptiste, it was just like my heels left, and like I noticed Ryan, like once Baptiste and Ryan kind of fell, it was kind of a lost fight in my opinion.
So
I'm throwing it out like as an idea.
Sure.
Like, would you say that also since soldiers like a bit of more of like far range, do you think it would be better for him to be over here where everyone else is, or do you think he'd be better if he was like high ground, like up there with
like
the cameras?
Right here. Yeah.
Like there or the other side, I would say.
Like,
but mostly like it depends like where Zen goes and then where soldier would go.
Yeah, exactly. So I would say like because you guys have this long range team, you well, that's something we can also discuss later, kind of what you need to do depending on the team comp, depending on what kind of team you have exactly, but mainly what you're looking for is to think about taking angles and making sure you have someone sat like on maybe this high ground, right? Like maybe someone can be over here, and because you do that, in theory, like as we said before, because they are gonna be facing all their defensive cooldowns this way here. Their matrics, their shields, they're gonna be faced this way. Because we're taking an angle, we can avoid all of that and try to potentially do a little bit more damage on them. And if we do damage on the enemy team this way, like maybe we're putting our damage like with a Zenyatta or Soldier, that's really, really good because you're forcing enemy resources such as maybe Baptiste shift, maybe again you can force his immortality field, but because you guys were stacking here together, if you take a look at what's going to be happening is that all of your cooldowns just simply going to be blocked, all of your shots going to be blocked. If you take a look right here, we're all stacking together, and then the D.Va, if you take a look like how much she ate right there, yeah, like see, she's eating a lot, and then we're going in, she's going in now, and this position you also don't have exactly like the good vision on the enemy. Now we don't have good opportunities to put a lot of pressure because everyone's stacked in the same area, sort of. All of your cooldowns can be blocked by the Rein Shield and D.Va, and that allows them to actually win the map. So it's all about specifics, it's all about the thinking about how to set up. That's what I said before. So first of all, ult tracking, because here you don't have any ults, we don't want to do ult tracking, we just want to think about the plan depending on what kind of team comp we have, and then we do setup. Here it's all about setup. Setup went kind of wrong here. That's why we lost this one. Okay, let's kind of maybe move forward and see what's the next fight. How the next fight's gonna be. What kind of plan you can have potentially also? What do you think? So right now, we also switch to Monkey, we have a Moira, mm-hmm. So, what kind of plan we can have here? What do you think?
Well, the Monkey was to try to get the Genji, because he's going to be very close, and Monkey can kind of just get anything when it's in front of him.
Yeah, I'll say like...
And then the McCree is also just to stun the Genji.
I'd agree with that, yeah. I was also trying to do it like just in case for the... Even though it's a bit harder to get them, I would say like Echo and Mercy. Even though it's like a little bit harder.
Yeah,
Echo and Mercy.
Kinda, like, for them too.
Because, you know, if you like save your jump and then Mercy flies away, you can then use the jump for like added on damage or a kill.
Sure, sure. Yeah, I would say that's kind of like decent plan to me. Really, in terms of planning, it's really, really important to know that sometimes your plan can be not ideal, right? But if you're on the same page, most likely that's gonna work. That's gonna be getting a lot of value in a fight. I always like to say, when you're trying to make a plan, when you're trying to like do certain thing, if you think about this, if one on the map is doing something like, let's say, you have a Monkey trying to go in by himself here, okay? So if he's trying to go in by himself here, most likely it's gonna be sort of a feeding move, because everyone's just gonna be focused on him, the entire attention is gonna be on this Monkey, well, nothing good's gonna happen. So when you doing something alone, that's a feeding, but when you guys doing things together, that's a strategy. That's how I would like to phrase it, honestly, because right here you're potentially going after the Echo, as you said, trying to go after Baptiste. If you're doing it together, that's gonna give you a lot of value, potentially getting a kill, potentially forcing their resources, and also staying alive, which is important. Like later, obviously, once you're done with kind of having consistent plan and making sure you're on the same page, you need to work on quality of the plan, but that's something we can do later, obviously, if we want to do more sessions in the future. That's something we can look for, to work on the quality of the plan and talk about this a little bit more. Let's see here. We starting the fight, our monkey went in. Yeah. So, is it good or not at this moment? Like, what we are we in the same page or not? Let's phrase it this way.
No, I don't think so. Because I tried going in, and then like everyone was being pressured by like the off-angled Echo, the D.Va, I would say.
Exactly.
I mean, Giraffe, you're Reinhardt, so like, correct me if I'm wrong.
Well, I saw you jump in, so I started to try to work my way up, and then. I mean, I didn't call out that I was moving up, so nobody else came up with me. I didn't even know. I knew, but I didn't know that they were pressuring that hard on the far left side.
So exactly, like you see how Reinhardt just said. For example, like you didn't know that this jump was happening, like will be happening specific, and that's why.
Yeah, I don't think I called it out either. So that was like.
Once I saw him land, I was like, "Oh, okay, let's try to get a pick here." So I pushed up.
Exactly, and that's
why. He jumped back, so I didn't go all the way through with it.
Exactly, and that's why phrasing it in a way like, "Okay, guys, we have a fight. Let's ult track first, and then later, let's think about our plan, what we do, when we do, and where we do it." So. In terms of what we just said, I think, again, you can maybe correct me, we can go after Deco or Baptiste. But then, when we do it? What do you think about when, Bart?
I would imagine, at least for the BAP, I would say it would be more for, like, when the main tank moves in or when the team moves in. Usually BAP likes to stay either... Exactly. Either A, he likes to stay within the team, or B, he likes to stay like on the outside. So mainly when the main tank passes and the players pass,
exactly,
will be the healer.
Yeah. So
for Echo, it seems like because she likes off angles.
Okay.
Like because she's doing it right now, and she did it like before a little bit. I would imagine someone being at the ready for an off angle, or if I had like a jump to, then jump to that angle.
Yeah, or just. Kind of really specific thing, I would say, well, you can maybe have a plan around the Echo. It's just, my opinion, it's going to be a little bit harder because the Echo is a really high mobility target, and not everyone can actually close the distance with Echo. Like, your Reinhardt will have troubles dealing with Echo because of her mobility. Same about Moira, sort of same about the Kree, while McCree is here, which can shoot from far range, but you also want to kind of, like, make sure that you're able to use your abilities when you're doing kind of crafting the plan, making a plan. Like right here, maybe when we're trying to close the distance with Baptiste, most likely that's gonna be good. Most likely we will execute it because our McCree will be able to use Flash, our Moira will be useful at the short range, user Winston will be useful too, Soldier can be just poking from really, really far, Reinhardt closing the distance. So all of that sort of works better. But it's kind of more about quality of the plan anyway. But once you know what you do, when you do it and where, no one's gonna be surprised. They will just know what is happening, and they will be with you on the same page, and this way you will get value. Yeah, maybe right here you're going in after their Baptiste. I would say it's not that bad if your team can follow up, because when you're doing that, you're forcing resources such as maybe Baptiste jump, or maybe they are gonna use shift. That's actually kind of pay closer attention. The Baptiste is, yeah, exactly, using shift right here, and that's a resource. And when he did that, if your team can follow up, that can potentially lead to a kill. Yeah, if Baptiste don't have that shift, we can try to most likely get a kill on him. So that's why it's important. Okay. Do you guys have any questions, maybe, or everything's clear?
No, I understand everything you're saying.
Yeah, I understand too.
Nice, okay. Maybe we actually have more time to take a look at the other map, because I think...
Wait, there's like two maps. One I had to...
I think we had Li Jiang Tower.
What's the Li Jiang Tower? Is it the second one or the third one?
I think we started with the first one. Wasn't it the first one, I think?
Yeah, that was the first one.
Yeah.
That's,
I haven't played a game that much, just saying.
Dorado was the second one.
Yeah, Dorado is the second one. Do you want me to review Dorado or try to
Dorado
like...
Dorado made me sad.
I guess we can do the first map, although I did like, I tried to play DPS on there. I don't think, I'm not sure how well I did or not.
Oh, the first map, that one guy wasn't actually on our team. Like, yeah, Ski wasn't actually there, and we just kind of had to pull someone random.
I'm just not sure, because for me, the first one was your Anubis one. Do you have your first one just saved as a replay code? Or?
Anubis was actually our third one.
Yeah,
this was our second.
Like, a little bit out of order, but yeah, I sent like the
code. Oh, no, this was our first.
This is your first.
This one was our first. No, oh, okay. It wasn't first. This one was our first, and then Ski came back.
And
then
Dorado.
The second map that you were on, which was the Dorado one, that was the second one, mm-hmm. and then Temple of Anubis was the third one.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Well, then, do you want to start with this one then? The first one, yeah?
Sure.
Sure,
I guess. This isn't our normal comp setup, though, so I feel like there's going to be a lot of things for you to point out.
Yeah, because Nick was playing DPS, and we had some dude playing tank.
Yeah, we literally had to pull a random person because we couldn't find a sixth person.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, it's happening sometimes, right? Mm. So maybe let's talk about here. What is your idea? What kind of plan you can have for this team comp? Like, maybe let's start with basics again. What do you guys think about your range? At what range you're gonna be fighting?
Close.
Probably close range. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then, what about the specific plan? What you gonna be doing? So,
I would imagine that we would try to... Well, with Lucio, we would try to use his... Well, first, technically with Sim, we use the TP here.
Sure.
And then Lucio amps it. I believe he's amping it up right now.
Yeah, he is.
So I feel like our objective here would be to either A, try to straight up move to point so Sim can put down her turrets, or B, try to lock down the doorway area with, again, Sim's turrets and us being there first.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's talk about kind of thinking. So, let's talk about setting up around the point. What do you think is the main concern about setting up on the point versus these guys here?
The main concern would be that hallway. Like, there'd be two. One, I would say, is if they had like a more of a long range team, they can use like corners and whatnot on that part.
Exactly.
To try to eventually look for, like, to go in after a kill, or to go in with abilities, and the other problem would be if they go on top, like, on the side, like, where we are right now, if they try, because then they can go straight, or on the outside, or inside.
Yeah, so the main concern, if we phrase it, like, in a short way, when you take in the point, when you stay in there, kind of setting up there, if you're not looking to close a distance with anyone, you're allowing the enemy team to play their long range. So once they play long range, what they're gonna do, they just can maybe set up an additional angle, like maybe someone can go here, maybe someone can go there. Yeah, that's why it's important to like find a way to close your distance, do it at the right moment, save your cooldowns right here. Let's actually see, like, are we gonna fight at the short range or not? Because this moment it feels like we're taking this site here, kind of blocking it with a sim turret, sure. So like right here, we did block the entrance, okay? And then later, we're using bubbles there, we're still pressuring the enemy Reinhardt, okay? Mm-hmm. Let's actually see. Maybe still winnable fight here. Mm-hmm. Okay. So what do you think you guys could be doing better here? It seems like we got this space now, right? We got this high ground. That's pretty advantageous position. But then later, see what's happening at this moment. Yeah, we're trying to go in, but how we do it? What about our specifics? What about our resources? What do you guys think you could be doing in terms of using your resources there? Do you have any ideas?
No.
Mm-hmm. I would imagine maybe, like, because Lucy already used the speed boost, maybe trying it again to then close the distance.
Mm-hmm. Okay, okay.
I would imagine that would be one possibility. I'm not sure if I
use my immort. like when we get low HP and we can just start rushing them.
Okay. So in terms of specifics, let's kind of phrase it this way. When we're trying to close a distance with enemy, what cooldowns we need, where we need to, let's start with thinking like where we need to set up and yeah, what kind of cooldowns we need again. So in terms of bubbles, maybe let's start with Zarya. Yeah. We need bubbles here at this moment. We need to bubble Dryne, right? We need to our cell bubble as well. What about Haley? What about you? What do you need? Like, but this immortality field, sure. What else?
Maybe save my shift.
Yeah. Also, we need the shift. What about the Lucia?
Is Amp.
Exactly. Yeah. So all of this, that's kind of. That's what we kind of need at this moment. And if you take a look, when we trying to close the distance, see what's going wrong, our Reaper is here, but then we taking a fight, kind of like blocking the damage here, because our Reaper is taking the fight already going on aggressive, because the entire attention is going to be on him, because we kind of not at the same page at this moment. Because of that, his cooldown is going to be forced, so his shift is going to be forced, and later we have to bubble as well, and that's kind of, you know, snowballs one thing after another when you're not on the same page, when you're not using your resources at this like right time at the right moment. This kind of things are going to be happening, because right now, yeah, because we used bubble and Reaper, we cannot bubble the Rhine. And later, maybe we also have to use shift here. Let's actually see. Did we use the shift or not? Not yet, yeah, but still. Potentially, shift can be forced, most likely, because this guy's gonna take a lot of damage here. Okay. So, yeah, that's something you can be looking for in terms of specifics. Making this call, making sure everyone's on the same page. In terms of setup, by the way, when you do go in, when you take in a fight, also you can try to send someone an off angle, like your Reaper mainly is the person here who could be on off angle. So let's say these guys are doing something like this, closing the distance. Your Reaper can be around here, trying to take an off angle this way, and find a way to not deal with their shield, not deal with their defensive abilities, and this way.
I think, sorry, I think I actually not what you're showing right now, but I think I do either this push or the next push. I try like where I am. I try going down the hallway to try to pick off like the healer.
Yeah, exactly. And if you do that, if you actually do that simultaneously with what your team do, so well, let's say you're on their backline, yeah, because everyone's going to turn around to deal with you. If they do so, your main core can actually kind of do their things, try to push up and use that. Yeah, use that attention which they are giving you if that happens. That's why kind of being on the same page here is important. For sure, but let's take a look what's gonna happen later. We are resetting, okay?
Yeah, I think here we just kind of, I remember I called it, we needed to like back up because three of us died.
Yeah, that makes sense. That makes sense, totally.
And okay. Then I think, like Haley, just remind me if I'm wrong or not, but I do remember that we should, like, I called out that we should, and I think you did even too, where we were like, we should just go left.
Yeah, you guys said we'd just go left.
Because they have a junk, right? So they're going to be watching the door a lot. At least if we go left, we have a chance to, like, push around the junk and maybe get in, like, a better position besides just, like, running straight into the door and it doesn't work and we're, like, stuck in there.
Yeah, exactly. So like right here, why it's also really, really good in terms of fundamentals, just fundamentally, why it's good doing so versus their team. What do you guys think? If you just go in this way? Mm-hmm.
I would say their team kind of, in a strange way, punishes straightforward, like, approaches if everyone's like in the same mindsets. Like, for example, like that sounds really weird, but like, let me explain. Like, Zen can Discord Orb to stop a push in, right?
Sure.
Junk can use bombs to stop a push forward. Zarya can bubble people so it negates damage. Ryan has a big shield, you know?
Yeah, exactly. All of that. So you're really right there. So when you, let's say, kind of trying to take a fight here, trying to close the distance with enemy from the main, because you guys, your rotation will be looking like this. This entire time, you will be playing kind of in more openish spaces if we compare it to this kind of side of where you're going to. Because right here, we can phrase it this way, if we are playing at the space where the enemy team can utilize their long range heroes more, such as Zenyatta, such as Ana, such as Junkrat. So continuously, while we'll be walking, they will be spamming us. That means we are going to be forced to use our resources, who knows, like bubbles, maybe our amp, maybe our Reaper shift, maybe our Baptiste shift and Reinhardt shield. Yeah, so while we'll be doing that, because we are forced to use those cooldowns, this enemy team, they have an advantage over us, because we simply fighting at their favorable range. But once we are inside this building, once we starting the fight from there, we just easily able to avoid all the damage. We gonna be closing the distance with our full shield. Most likely we're gonna have our amp too, and our Baptiste lamp. So yeah, like, take a look at you guys. So right now, you have all of your resources, so that's perfect rotation right here, okay? And then you guys go looking to close the distance. I think it's going right, yeah. And see, in terms of specifics, we also get a lot of value, and as you said, you're taking an angle here, and you can see how it benefits your team. Because if you take a look, this guy's gonna be destructed with you, but because they are destructed, like this Junker that Tracer is shooting you, this main core can actually find value. What's happening on the map? They can try to look to push in the swine, they can like try to push in the rest of their team, and this way win the fight. Okay. Yeah, so that went really well. Let's take a look at the what's gonna happen next. If we kind of think about the plan here, how perfect plan would look like? What do you think?
A perfect plan, like including ults?
Should we include ults?
Well, yes.
Probably yes. Right?
So, let's assume that it's like a perfect world, right? So, perfect plan would be Junk has his ult.
Okay.
We respond with the Lucio ult, or with the Ana slash Rein ult, because I'd imagine, you know, Reinhardt does his ult and Ana nanos, or maybe it's vice versa, Ana nanos and then hammer down.
Okay.
Whatever the case may be, I feel like Lucio's ult and also Baptiste's immortality would probably be the main focus for like when they use it. And then after they use it, I would imagine the perfect plan would be to whittle down Rein's shield or eliminate it or kill Rein, whatever it would be, so that there's no protection. And then hopefully I can use like my ult maybe, or Baptiste can use like his ult to do the damage.
Okay. So what you mentioned there, you sort of kind of created a plan around the around the Junkrat ultimate, right? And
well, I would say Junk or Reinhardt, I would say.
Okay. So when they are gonna use ultimate, we're saying we're gonna use our own ultimate. Okay, so let's face it this way. Ult, so like enemy, and then we gonna respond, maybe even do this kind of like, we're gonna respond with our ultimate, okay? what's the problem with this kind of plan? What do you think? So if enemy gonna use the ultimate first and then we responding, what is the main concern about it?
I guess
that someone will die. Mm-hmm. I think that someone get picked off early.
Yeah, I would say like fundamentally, I guess, would be that technically we're letting them use their ults first if we were to go by this plan.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So then that means that stuff could go wrong first rather than us initiating it and then them using their ults. So, like, for example, I guess a better way of doing it would be, I would imagine using Lucio's, like, for example, if I use my ult, right?
Uh-huh.
Zen has to use his ult. Okay. I would imagine.
Yeah.
Zen would want to protect against my ult.
Like, and that's correct. I just want to say, like, really, what you just described there, that's basically what we want to say, and a proactive plan. We want to always have somewhat a proactive plan. Why? Because we are in control of our ultimates. We are responding what we're doing with them. We can use the window, we can use the Reaper, yeah, we can use the Lucius ultimate. But when you kind of creating a plan around what they have and sort of respond to their ultimate, then usually it's not gonna end up that well, because, well, first of all, maybe they're not gonna use their ultimate. Like, maybe you imagining they're gonna use their shadow, or like they try to use their tire, but they're not gonna do that. And then you're like, oh, what do we do then? Yeah, what? How do we win? It's so really important to always kind of think about, well, what do we do now? How do we win now? Even though sometimes you will have situations when you don't have any ultimates, and this guy's enemy team, they have all six ultimates. You still want to have somewhat plan which allows you to win in theory, kind of. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. So, yeah, exactly. Like, having this proactive plan, making sure you do things first. So, maybe, let's say, they have a tire. Well, sure. Well, let's think about what we can do here. Maybe try to go for a window first. This way, we'll be forcing their resources, we'll be forcing their ultimates. They'll be using shatters, like, whatever. But then, because we actually did set up this plan, because it was proactive, we can get much more done, because yeah, we're in control of that, but we're not in control of the what the enemy is gonna do. So yeah, it's all gonna be more about kind of specifics, how you set up, how you execute your plan again, the quality of the plan is also really, really important, of course. But here we cannot hear what you guys say, but the would be interesting to see what we were planning, because okay, this moment, let's kind of take a look. We're taking a fight here. Our Reaper went down, unfortunately, but it's all right. Let's see what we're gonna do. Okay, so we're starting on the point and starting with window. Okay, I would say that's pretty good. If you did kind of communicate that, yeah, let's start with window, let's kind of make sure we get value around that window, that's good. But let's think about kind of location, where we use it, and when we use it. So what do you think about this? So what, yeah, that's a window, but what's the perfect time to use it, and where we could use it to get more value? What do you think?
Maybe like when they don't have like somewhere to like really hide behind, or like they have a more hard time like hiding behind like different corners to avoid it.
Exactly. Okay. Okay. So we could be saying in terms of when these guys are actually committed to push you guys, yeah, like kind of like once they're in a little bit more, we can use the window and just make it really, really hard for them to do anything, because they are sort of gonna be stuck in this space here. And if they are stuck in this space, that means we're forcing a lot of resources. If we're forcing a lot of resources, we have more chances to win. Versus the situation where we use our window a little bit early, and then because they are far, because they can avoid dealing with this window, they can simply hide, and the resource is not going to be forced, such as like anti grenades, yeah, again, like bubbles. So I would say, like, in terms of when actually maybe could be a little bit better, right? But still pretty decent, in my opinion, right? And in terms of where, also, what do you think about this spot here? Is it good or it could be a little bit different?
I think it'd be better maybe if I angled it maybe towards, like, maybe more towards the corner, like, that they're going to hide in. So we could have, like, maybe the opportunity to try and shoot them from, like, that angle, or DPS could try and shoot them from that angle.
Exactly, exactly, yeah. Actually doing that. So you guys are really, really smart, yeah? I mean, doing all of this, once you have this plan, once you're on the same page, once you know specifically what how you need to set up, how you need to use your cooldowns, once you know all that, you should be doing great. So like right here, if you potentially angle your window a little bit better, yeah, potentially maybe aiming, being able to aim towards these guys, or maybe you can even think like, okay, maybe letting them in a little bit more, and then using your window like maybe right here, because of it, they will not have really, really good cover, which we can use, because they will be forced. Let's imagine if we use our window like right here, because they went in and they are sort of stuck in this space, they will be forced to go behind this cover here or behind that cover, and because they do that, it will be really, really easy to push them. So you can always think about your Baptiste window like a zoning ultimate, sort of like a McCree ultimate too. And once you zone the enemy out in a certain locations, the main goal is to just make sure you can actually capitalize on it, make sure you can push it. That's why kind of letting them in a little bit more, or like angling your window, maybe starting here, I would say, even when they are this space here, actually makes sense, yeah? We always want to make sure that able to push that they don't have a decent cover around them, which they can use to, so you force even more cooldowns and resources. Well, if we kind of summarize a little bit, what do you guys need to pay attention to later? What are you guys gonna be working on from what we just discussed?
I would imagine it would be knowing, like, on both teams what ults they would probably have and mm-hmm. what ults we know that we have, and then making a plan with ults.
Sure, okay. So ult track, right? And then after that, kind of making a plan. That's basically your flow of the fight. If you think about this, first of all, ult tracking, and then the second thing you want to do is planning, paying attention to specifics, what you do, when you do it, and where you do things. Once you're on the same page, once your plan is proactive, should be good, really. It's so important to also in the future work on the quality of the plan, but for now, really making sure you at least have the plan and you on the same page to kind of execute it. That's what we need to do at this moment. So yeah, once you have a plan, also need to set up accordingly to that. Okay, anything else?
No.
I guess like better communication, maybe, mm-hmm. like with everyone. I don't know, like better positioning I'd probably work on, maybe.
Yeah, better positioning, that's something we can work on as well. Specifically everyone, every individual player, once you guys know, so you can sort of do those team VOD reviews and discuss this bigger picture. And once you know what the plan looks like, you can kind of also discuss specifics of what the every player should be doing. If we kind of connect to that plan, so let's say, yeah, like right here, we're using the window, and you playing Reinhardt, or like there is a Zarya on your team. We can say in terms of Reinhardt, what you can be aware of is making sure you have your E, making sure you maybe also have some potential additional shield to make sure you'll be able to push up the enemies later. In terms of Beeper, maybe having an angle, something like that. Yeah, all of those specifics, they are really, really important. But today, yeah, it's more of a understanding of the bigger picture. I just want to make sure we understand that first. Okay. Do you have any questions or everything's clear?
No, I understand.
Okay.
Yeah,
no question.
Okay.
No question is...
If everything's clear and if you don't have any questions, then I will see you guys later, and I'm gonna send you the summary of our session. I can do that. Maybe I can send it here, maybe in this channel if you want to, and you guys can be having this in front of you in your future games. Yeah, kind of working on everything step by step. It's really, really important.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Okay. And if you're gonna have any questions about Overwatch or just like in general about planning, communication, something like that, the things which we discussed today, feel free to message me on Discord. I always will try to answer when I can. Well, so
thank you.
Yeah. Well, then see you guys. I'm gonna go. Bye-bye.
Bye.
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 See ya.